we are here having the aim to be to estimate the power spectral density of the discrete time random process by using the current method DIP. Here we have the minimum variance spectrum estimation, or we can simply call it to be the MV technique or MV method. Here it should be a function first of all that can be able to be called upon into another scripts. I use the word function, and this function we expect to output us the power spectral density estimate. So that generally we denote in the MATLAB programming with the capital P small x, the variable. So in mathematics it is basically the estimate denoted by capital P cap. To the suffix, the method name is mostly mentioned, and if it is with respect to the discrete time random process, so the suffix is for the discrete time random process only. So here it is, this is the estimate of the power spectral density for the random process that can be denoted by x, hence px. So equal to sign it should be there, and the name of the function. So for minimum variance spectrum estimation, I mention min underscore variance. This is the name of the function to which the input arguments can be listed within the parenthesis here. So here we expect only two input operands. So these are the most important discrete time random process without which we cannot demonstrate the same, that is denoted by x, and along with we require small p as another input argument. So as x we are very well familiar with, small p is nothing but the order of the minimum variance estimate that we shall typically obtain here. Now this particular sentence should be also followed by the keyword AND here. So in between the two keywords function and AND, we have to develop the MATLAB script so that this minimum variance method can give us the output, that is px, corresponding to the input value of x and that of the order p here. So let us save this. To save this function, the same name is carried, so min underscore variance dot m, it will be the file extension. See, it has been now generated into the current folder, as well the name has appeared onto the editor window tab here. Now for this minimum variance, as we are now well familiar with the x requirement and the p requirement, so x we obtain as an input argument and again assign it with the same name, where the total number of samples are assigned to it. Hence x is equal to x within the parenthesis colon here we have given. Now next to that, for the spectrum estimation with the help of the minimum variance technique, here we require the autocorrelation matrix that can be denoted by capital R in general. So it has to be computed, and for such computation we require the covariance and the convolution matrix functions. So here we take the help of such a function that we can name it by COVR, covar, where the input operands are x, p, the same input operands that this minimum variance function is supposed to take here. So this is not the inbuilt MATLAB function that we have to develop here and that can result into the matrix R that we can process further here. So for that purpose, let us take the another untitled script where we can have the development of this covar function here. So here we start again, as this is the function to be called in another function. Again, the keyword here, function, that is to be resulted with the matrix denoted by capital R, the function name covar, and here the input operands are x, p here. So this sentence should be followed by the keyword AND, and in between the two, as it is expected to have generation of the covariance matrix of the order p by p, that is the second input operand here. So we first of all start with accepting the discrete time random process x is equal to x within the parenthesis colon here, followed by the semicolon to suppress the output, And now we also need to operate onto the length of this input discrete time random sequence. So that can be stored with the help of variable name small m. So the value of the entire discrete time random process can be given by the function length here. So length, this function is to be operated over x here. By the next line, this x is to be computed by having x minus the array of ones holding the dimensions m, 1 in multiplication to the summation of x, and the summation is to be divided by m. We end it with the help of semicolon, and now further this particular capital R is to be obtained by the use of convolution matrix here. So for that purpose we need to take the help of another function. So that function here we can denote it by convm here, where m is the length here. So now the input operands to this particular function are x, p again, and it is also operated the way here we have the same function convm, the input operands x, p, and this is divided by, within the bracket we have small m minus 1 here. Now we save this with the name covar into the same MATLAB folder here, and as this is the function we are taking the help for obtaining the solution matrix here, that can be finally denoted by capital R. So this is of course again not the MATLAB inbuilt function, that we have to again develop it separately. So in this regard we take again the another MATLAB untitled script here and mention here the keyword function. The output we require in terms of the variable here we in general denote by capital X, and the function name convm, whereas the input parameters are the same as like the previous two functions x, p, and this is to be followed by the end function. So this function generates a convolution matrix, and for the given the vector x or the discrete time random sequence, you can say having the length capital N in total, the convolution matrix is of the order capital N plus p minus 1 by small p here, the order that we get it as an input from the parenthesis shown here. So now first of all we make computation of capital N that we have talked about. So this is nothing but the entire length of the discrete time random sequence x to be added by 2 in multiplication to p minus 2, of course it is. And here by the next line we accept the another input, that it is x as a function of all the values in the colon here we provide, and end it with the help of semicolon. Now we have the computation of another variable called as xpad, and that can be the array here denoted that starts with the function zeros here. All the values will be of zero. The dimensions are p minus 1, 1, semicolon, the x, the discrete time random process, and again the function of zeros. So it is p minus 1, 1 here. So with these many rows, this will be saved particularly. Now we can make the use of for looping here. So for statement, we start over here with the index variable that is denoted by I, that starts the iterations at the value of I is equal to 1 up to the order that we obtain as input to this function, that it is p. And for these many iterations, the computation of the output variable x Within the parenthesis, we have all the dimensions, comma, I for which the iteration is to be performed here. So this is obtained by having x pad, and here we have p minus I added to 1 colon, here we have capital N minus I plus 1 here. So we end this with the help of semicolon. So this function is also to be saved here with the same name, convm, to the current directory here. Now after saving this particular function convm that has been used into the function covar, we get this r here, and that it is used into the function that we are developing, that is for the minimum variance spectrum estimation technique here. So after obtaining capital R, by the next step we require to work with the eigenvalues here and the eigenvectors in general. So we store this information with respect to the eigenvalue, eigenvector, into the variable names v, small t here. And for obtaining this information, the MATLAB function is nothing but EIG, whereas the input is capital R, the matrix that we have obtained in the above step. Now, as we can see, the mathematical representation of the power spectral density estimate by the use of minimum variance spectrum estimation technique, the mathematical formula, thereupon we have the use of capital U also into the RHS. So U can have been calculated by the use of the matrix function as it is to be operated for the case of diagonals. Here is the function syntax DIAG, and it is of course to be operated over the inverse of the matrix. So here we write INV, and to be operated for the absolute value of small t, the information that we have obtained regarding the eigenvalues, eigenvectors in the above step here, and this is further to be added by EPS. So it is the floating point space for the numbers here, and we end it with the help of semicolon. So U has been computed here. Now we require capital V to be computed. So this capital V is nothing but the Fourier transformation. So of course the absolute value, the magnitude, as we need to show. So for Fourier transformation we use the FFT command for first computation here, and absolute of the FFT of the input is small v, as we have opted with the function name EIG, and here it is with 1024, as the same we have used throughout for the MATLAB demonstrations of the power spectrum estimation techniques in this particular chapter, and it holds the power of the two. So every element here, ending it with the help of semicolon. Now we finally make the computation of the estimate of power spectral density for the input discrete time random process X. So it is denoted by PX, and as we expect it to be computed into the decibels here, simply we mention 10 in multiplication to the log to the base 10 of, here we have small p, minus here we have 10 in multiplication to log to the base 10, or the multiplication, that is the product of V matrix into the U matrix that we have just now computed here. We give semicolon at the last here. So this completes the MATLAB script for our function minimum variance here. So this minimum variance uses the computation of the covariance matrix R here, that can be accomplished by the function by the use of the convolution matrix like this here, that can be provided by the letter X here. So now this function minimum variance is to be called upon to process a discrete time random process, a discrete time random sequence here, with the help of the concerned method here. So in this regard we again take the new MATLAB script here, whereupon we can start upon the execution. So before the execution, we require the discrete time random process to be generated here. So we start this particular script with, first of all, close all, clear CLC. Next to that, we take a module to generate a discrete time random process. So various ways of generating the discrete time random process into the MATLAB that we have seen into right from the third video, whereupon the demonstration of the periodogram technique was made. Now we assign the manual values to the variable x. So for example, as like the previous cases, we take the time samples here. Let us say the first sample is nothing but -0.9. The second sample value, let us say 2.3. The third sample value, we select 5.6. The fourth sample, minus, here we take 4.5. The fifth sample, 6. Sixth sample, here we take 2.5. Seventh sample, we take minus, here we take 3.5. Next to that, we take 4.8. So here we have in total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and now the two samples here we generate 4.5 and into the negation -6.7. so 10 samples we have assigned to it. So let us save this particular script, and the name here it can be execute_min_variance here. So we save it with the .m as the file extension. The file has been created. This is the function file, and here it is the execution file. So the change you can notice, this is a function representation, and this is the entire MATLAB script here, whereupon the function is to be called upon. So upon running this particular file, we expect the workspace variables of the earlier programmings to get first of all cleared, and then only one variable x should be there upon. So let us check. Yes, so upon running this particular program, you can check here, for the variable x we have the values denoted. The values are -0.9, 2.3, 5.6, -4.5, 6, 2.5, -3.5, 4.8, 4.5, -6.7. So let us visualize the values graphically, where we can make the use of stem function. The input can be of course x here. Just saving the changes to the script and running it again. So we obtain a separate window with the name figure 1, where we can have the first sample, the amplitude marked here, second sample, the third sample, fourth sample, the fifth sample, here it is, it holds the amplitude 6. Next to that, we have 2.5, the 7th sample -3.5, 8th sample 4.8, 9th sample 4.5, the 10th sample holds the amplitude level, that is -6.7 here. So this window I close, and for such a input discrete time random process, now the second module here, it can be to estimate the spectrum here. So I write, or simply, the spectrum estimation. Spectrum estimation. So for spectrum estimation purpose, we have to call upon this function. You can see the syntax. So this is px is equal to minimum variance, having the two input operands here. Now here we call upon it. So the output variable px, that is to be obtained, the function name min_variance, and now the input is of course the discrete time random process x that has been generated with the 10 samples in the above step, comma, here we can have the order, for example 4. So that is the value of P here. So let us save the changes, and we expect into the workspace another variable along with X, that it is PX generated with the spectrum estimation information. So here, as we have provided the input to the minimum variance function to be the discrete time random process X, and here the value of P is equal to 4. Let us save the changes and check whether into the workspace we have the another variable with the name PX or not. So let us run this particular program. We have been provided with the figure 1 with the display of the input random process, and yes, into the workspace we have now the two variables. One is the X that here we have, and another is the PX here. Now we have this particular figure. In this figure we have the plot of the discrete time random process, the alternative here we have to be, that is the display of the discrete time random process having the 100 samples in all. If alternate way, the first one, if you want to visualize, so that time also we can run and see the changes. So this is what the input that we have already seen, minus 0.9, 2.3. next to that we have the third sample with the amplitude 5.6 that we have defined in this particular MATLAB sentence here. So for such a corresponding discrete time random process, either by this way the manual assignment, or by this way where the random values will be generated for the 100 samples, so we have obtained the power spectrum estimate folded up by this variable into the workspace. Now afterwards there it is a task to have plot of the same. So here we take the module to plot the spectrum estimate. So for plotting purpose we require a separate figure window here, hence the keyword figure, and we can make the use of plot function and provide it with the input variable PX that holds the spectrum estimate information. So saving the changes and running this particular program. Now you can see here it is the first figure, the discrete time random process that has been manually assigned to the variable X here, and here it is the plot of the spectrum estimate here. So now you can visualize the values, those have been plotted into this frequency domain. So for the total number of X is equal to 1024 samples here. So the various values have been plotted, and the curvature, the way with which it varies onto this frequency domain, that we can see here. So here I close this. So this way we have simply demonstrated the minimum variance spectrum estimation technique, and here we complete the understanding for the same.